everyone. Welcome back to DIY with Danica. And if this is your first time, then welcome. If you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe and tell a friend to do the same. Before we get started with today's tutorial, I just want to point out that I am wearing a pair of my favorite Michelle Obama earrings. Made these myself. If you're interested in them, then please check out the description box where I will put a link to my Etsy store. I get tons of compliments on these, and since I was in the mood for crafting, I decided to wear a craft that I made myself. Now, before we could get into today's tutorial, one last thing, there's a little backstory on this one. So about a couple months ago, early spring, I made a video on how you can do an Easter wreath for your front door, and it came out great. I will also put that in the description box. But now that Easter's gone and the wreath is down, I have this nail just sticking in my door. I think I'll post a picture right there. And when I come home, it just feels like something needs to be there. So I have been wanting to make a summer wreath. So today we will be making a summer wreath. I have not made this summer wreath before, so this will be a growing and learning experience, or as I like to say, an adventure. For this tutorial, you will need the following materials. I got most of my materials, practically all of my materials, from Dollar Tree because I love Dollar Tree. So the first thing I got from Dollar Tree is this wreath form. It is 14 inches and it costs $1. You will also be needing some wood clothespins, and these are the regular size. When you go to Dollar Tree, you will find some mini ones. They're like this small. I actually bought a pair. Okay. You do not want those for our video. So we want regular sized wood clothespins, and we need at least 3 bags. You will need something that you're going to embellish your wreath with. So I'm going to be using flowers, and yellow always makes me think of summer. I am also going to be using some butterflies. I have a yellow one and a pink one. All of these things I got from Dollar Tree, each one was $1. The last thing, well, it's not the last thing, but for the wreath that I will be using are spray paints. I did not get these spray paints at Dollar Tree. If you really wanted to make sure that your craft was completely Dollar Tree, you could use the little paint bottles that you find and just paint your clothespins. But in the interest of time, I'm going to be spray painting my clothespins. I have a sparkly silver and I have a white. I got both of these at Home Depot. The white was only $1. I was shocked. The brand is called Quick Color and they sell these spray paints for $1. The sparkly silver is the Rust-Oleum brand, and I can't remember how much it was. It couldn't have been more than like maybe $6 or $7. So I'm going to be using those. You will also be needing a glue stick and your glue gun. One more thing you'll be needing. Finally, we have a use for these annoying papers that they send us in the mail. Just to make sure that I don't make too much of a mess when I'm spray painting, I'm going to lay my wreath and my clothespins on these sales papers, and I'm going to be doing it out in my backyard. So let's go there and get started. Okay, so I am out in my backyard, and I have taken the time to switch into a pair of old stretch pants and old shoes that I don't really care about, that I never wear in public. So if you're going to do anything with paint, you always want to make sure that you have on something where you can, it won't be a big deal if you get paint on it. If you're a kid, make sure you get help from a parent and permission from a parent before you spray paint or paint anything. I have my, let me switch this around. Oh, I don't know if I can. I have my clothespins set up here. You can see them. My clothespins and my wreath. My clothespins and my wreath set up. I'm going to be spraying 42 because I did my math, I did my multiplication. I'm going to be spray painting 42 of them white and 42 of them silver. And I think I'm going to spray paint the wreath silver also. And I'm going to be doing it quickly because it is hot out here and your girl is sweating. I don't like that. All right, let's do this. Okay, you'll also probably want to test the direction of the wind before you spray paint to make sure that it doesn't blow back in your face. So I've already done that. I can tell by the way the paper is flipping up. And I'm gonna just get close enough. And it is blowing away from me. Since the paint, the wind is blowing in that direction, I probably don't want to paint the silver and have it blow back into the white, you know? So I am going to give one last coat of this white. This one too. And then I am gonna let that dry. Let's see what this silver can do. Ooh, it's sparkly. Wow, I'm not sure if you can tell on the camera, but that looks really great. It looks glittery. I'm gonna let those dry for a bit. I'm gonna flip them over and do the same thing to the other side. And next time you see me, I will be back in my creating studio, also known as my office, also known as the place where I exercise. And I will be putting together the wreath. Okay, I'm back in the crafting zone. I have my wooden clothespins that are painted. This one is the sparkly silver, and these are white. And I'm noticing that there's not much of a visual difference between the two from a distance. Up close, I can tell the difference. So hopefully it's gonna look good. I also decided to paint my wreath so that just in case if it shows through in any parts, it won't be black and standing out against the white door and the light colored clothespins. So step two, the next thing I need to do is to attach the clothespins to the wreath. I don't think I'm going to be using any glue for this. When I tested earlier in order to get an estimate of how many clothespins I needed, I noticed that they attach to this wreath really securely, so I don't think I'll be wasting my glue on that. Let's do it. I think I'm just gonna do a 1-to-1 color ratio, like one silver, one white, one silver, one white. I am clipping them. I'm going to start with the second ring from the center, and I'm clipping as far down as I can go. If you just clip on in the first, okay, the pins have these openings. There's one hole here, and there's a hole further back. If you just clip on this first hole, then it's gonna be wobbly. But if you open it up as far as you can and make sure that the wire goes into this last hole, then it'll be secure. So to demonstrate what I mean, I clip it in the first hole, then it's wobbly. But if I clip it and go as far as I can, then it's secure. So that's what I'm going for. I have a silver, and then I'm going to do the white on the second from the outer edge. So there's the inner edge, there's the outer edge. So again, going as far back as I can and right next to it. I'm doing it, both of them above the wire. So you have different options, whatever you think looks best. So I have 1/7 of it done. See how that looks. And I will come back when I have the whole thing close pinned. I'm back. It did not take me long at all. It took me maybe 5 minutes, maybe. And I have the whole wreath completed. I think it looks really good just like this on its own. However, I am going to embellish it with some yellow flowers and the butterflies. Like I said, those are optional. You might want just a plain wreath, but if you do any looking on Pinterest or online, you will see so much creativity and so many things that you can do with these types of wreaths. With these type of flowers, I've used them before and said it before, when you're cutting them, you simply cut around the plastic and bend it where you cut and it will snap off. So I'm going to just lay some informally here and there, see how it looks before I permanently attach them with the glue. It's a beautiful day. So I have a basic idea of how I want my flowers to be laid out. I am about to start gluing them into position, and when I'm done, we'll see how it looks and if I feel like it's good or if I need to add something else, like some kind of bling that I have laying around somewhere. When you are gluing flowers, I sometimes find that it's helpful to actually glue the different parts of the flower. So for example, this flower has the yellow fabric portion, silk portion. I'm sure it's not silk since it came from Dollar Tree. And it has that green plastic part. I always just like to put a little dot of glue between that fabric and the plastic just so that the flower itself doesn't pull apart later on. So always put a little dab of glue there first before I start. And my glue stick is not cooperating. So a little tiny dab. This has to be the hottest glue gun that I own. It is literally like melting my blue working pad, and it has melted my tablecloth in the past. And it took a piece of my skin once when I was in high school. I've had this one a long time. Okay, back to my wreath. It's a beautiful day. Love is down.
broken by cloud. See the tuna fleets clear.
Here we have the final product. I think it came out really nicely. I can't wait to put it on my front door. I would have to say that this was one of the fastest DIY projects that I've done in terms of a wreath. Attaching the clothespins to the wreath was extremely fast. The most time probably was taken with spray painting the clothespins ahead of time. I have heard that you can get clothespins in different colors already, maybe not at Dollar Tree, but if you want to save yourself that time, then you might be able to look for some that are already in different colors. Adding the flowers, the butterfly just gave it an air of summer and it turned out great. So if you like this tutorial, please give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed yet, I can't figure out why, but please subscribe, everybody. And remember, if I can do this, you can do this. Thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned for the picture of the wreath on my door, and I will see you next time. Bye.